The State Bank of India has announced of launching an Islamic Equity Fund, the fourth of its kind in the country and the first by a state-owned entity. Market watchers are hopeful it can attract enough interest from a vast sector.
India's biggest lender, the State Bank of India, is calling it the Sharia Equity Fund, and sources say it's hoping to raise up to $16 million in its debut. After all, there is demand. The majority of India's 175 million Muslims remain largely excluded from the financial system because charging interest is prohibited in Islam. And only three other banks, Goldman Sachs, Tata and Taurus, offer such products.
There is a screening methodology adopted by Sharia Board, and that will certify that all those companies which are in the business of paying interest or receiving interest, it has been screened out. So all those stocks which are left out will be then considered for investments by the SBI fund manager.
That means funds invested in alcohol, gambling, pornography, pork and tobacco would not be considered. India's stock exchanges have between 600 to 700 companies that are Sharia compliant. SBI officials are also quick to stress that the Sharia Equity Fund is open to all customers irrespective of religion.
A lot of people who are following those religious strictures may not be at all investing because they were not sure whether to, you know, indulge in the market generally or not. Once you have a earmarked fund, earmarked structure for them, I'm sure they will start investing in the market, and I think this can be only a welcome development for the market as a whole.
Analysts say having a state-owned entity offer Sharia-compliant funds is a big step in the right direction. But unless full-fledged Islamic banks are finally allowed to set up in the country, India may find it hard to convince its Muslim community to jump in.